And it says from that time, many of his disciples went back and walked no more with him.
Thank you, God.
Then said Jesus unto the 12, will ye also go away?
Mm-hmm.
Then Peter answered, Lord, to whom shall we go? Thou hast the word of eternal life.
Lord.
And we believe and are sure that thou art that Christ. Jesus answered, then have not I chosen the 12, one of you is the devil.
My.
I want to preach on a subject this morning. It's you that I need. It's you that I need.
Yes.
Amen. That's something to get excited
yes.
about right there.
Thank you, God.
It's you that
Amen.
I need.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, God.
Amen.
Thank you.
Have just come out of a revival.
Yeah.
And had three wonderful nights. I thought
praise God.
Revival.
Yes.
Where the word of God was preached.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And it was preached powerfully.
Yes.
If you were able to receive it, you would have gotten something from the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But if you was looking for show and entertainment, you didn't get that on our three nights of revival.
Right. So
you got a powerful word that you would apply to your life. And I know that some have probably said in their heart, if we would have had someone else.
That's all right.
Come on. All right.
If we would have had someone else,
mm-hmm.
the church would have been full and running over. We would have had a high time.
Mm-hmm.
And the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
But a high time is not going to get you
come on.
To heaven.
Say so.
When all that you have is a high time,
mm-hmm.
when trouble comes,
say so.
All you're going to have is a high time.
No.
You won't have nothing to hold on to but a high time.
Mm-hmm.
And the question was that, what did the preacher on what you can't know, you don't know because all you had was a high time.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
Lord.
You get in trouble the next day and you think that you have something to sustain you or to hold you, but all you have is a high time. And
Lord.
When trouble comes, that high time won't hold you. The high time won't feed you. The high time won't sustain you. You've got to have a word from the Lord.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
When you get in trouble.
Mm-hmm.
Or when there's things that come up in your life and you don't know which way to go.
Glory be to God.
You need something to hold on to.
Oh, yes.
When it seems like everybody is walking away from you.
Yeah.
High time is not going to do it.
No.
Jumping and cutting flips across the chairs in the street is not going to do anything for you.
That's right.
Praise God.
You can say that I had a good time. We had a good time. We had a great time. But there's still, you have to wake up the Lord alive the next morning.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
And if the phone rings and you don't have nothing to hold on to, you don't have a word to hold on to. All you have is that man or that woman showing up preach. But you don't have nothing to hold on to. We find, and I'm not going to be before you long, but we find in our scripture where Jesus was talking about the bread and the
yeah.
wine. And he was dealing with his body.
Uh-huh.
And he had already had several disciples.
Mm-hmm.
But when Jesus began to teach about the bread and the wine, they just didn't have no understanding what Jesus was talking about.
Uh-huh.
And the Bible lets me know when things got hard for them. And when things get hard for you in your life, sometimes you'll walk away.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And we find that these disciples walked away from Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
And Jesus turned to the disciples and he asked the question, will you also go?
Mm.
Sometimes things get hard when you have no substance to hold on to. And that's what I'm trying to get the church to understand, is that when you have a word from God, when you have someone that's preaching to you and telling you some truths about God, that is from scripture straight from the Bible, telling you about God,
thank you, God.
You got something to hold on to. But when you got somebody that's giving you a good time, you don't have nothing to hold on to. And so when things get hard in your life, you find yourself walking away from things that you wouldn't ordinarily walk away from. And you walk away because you have nothing to hold on to. That's why you find people tipping in and out of the church.
Go ahead, preach out.
And that's why you find some churches filled up.
Say so.
No. But that's why you find some of them filled up, because they got what they want. They have an itching ear. They after the form of God, but denying the power thereof. And so when trouble comes in their life, they really have nothing to hold on to. Jesus turned to Peter says, now, where can we go?
Mm-hmm.
Glory be to God.
You have everything that we need.
Thank you, God.
If we didn't get it right during revival time, I'm going to ask you this question this morning. Where can you go?
I know. Glory be to God.
If you didn't receive anything from revival, where can you go?
Right.
If the word was preached during revival and you stand at a crossroads in your life, do not be like King Agrippa. Come on. Saying that you almost persuaded me.
That's all right.
The word was preached so powerful by Paul, his testimony. It wasn't preached to him preacher. It was his testimony about his conversion.
Thank you, God.
And Paul said, not only do I wish that you were just like me, but everybody that is surrounding me. In other words, where can you go once the word?
Come on, preacher.
If it's spread before you.
Yes, sir.
If you do not receive the word of God,
right now,
where can you go?
Bye.
Peter said, you gave us the word, and the word leads into eternal life.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, God.
What would you rather have? Eternal life or a good time?
Come on, preach it. Preach it up.
What would you rather have? Something that will hold you in the time of trouble, or would you just rather have a good time and go back home and talk about, Lord, we showed up, had a good time?
Come on, preach up. Lord,
amen. But I come to tell you this morning that I need something every day of my life that will hold me.
Glory be to God.
And you're talking about somebody that loves to have a good time. Sometimes I need something that would grab hold of my ear and make me think about my own self.
Yes, sir.
I need a word.
Yes, sir.
A life-changing word.
Yeah, amen. Hallelujah.
I'm tired of the good time.
Come on, preacher.
Tired of it. Hallelujah. We need a word that's going to give us some help from earthly glory.
Yes.
That's right.
Yes, sir.
That's what the church needs.
Yeah.
And if we're not going home getting into this. Being dedicated to the word of God.
Yeah. Amen.
Amen.
You'll almost be full, but you'll have just another room.
Say so.
But when one of the preachers stand up and give you a word,
yes.
That will satisfy your soul.
Yeah.
Stop waiting for the good time.
Good one.
Yes.
He said that we have seen you do miracles.
Yes.
We've seen the dead get up. We've seen the lame walk. We've seen the blind. We've seen the sight. I got enough sense, God, to know you are all that I need.
Yes.
Yes,
God.
Right.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
And this is what Peter said. And we believe and are sure that thou art the Christ, of the living God. Been around you long enough to know who you are.
Yes.
When you hang out with God
long
enough, you will know who He is.
Yes.
Because sometimes God will show up when you don't expect it. God will bless you.
Yes, sir.
Expect Him
to
bless you.
Yes, sir.
That's all right.
I understand that. Job even said, shall I receive good of the Lord and not evil?
Somebody else better than him.
Let me know. Then I would have to examine.
That's right.
Why I've been preaching this song.
Glory.
I just don't believe.
Glory to God.
You can find nobody better than Jesus. I don't believe it.
Glory.
I just don't believe it.
That's right. That's all right.
And I'm finished.
Glory. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory.
God is all that I need. Amen.
Glory. Hallelujah.
I don't care what people tell you.
Praise God.
What they say about you.
Hmm.
When you have come to the conclusion that God is all you need, walk with God. From earth to glory, God will walk with you.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Huh?
It seems like that you're walking by yourself.
Lord.
That old sign, that old poem said, footprint in the sand.
Mm-hmm.
Lord, there were times in my life when trouble was all around.
That's right.
And I thought you would have been there.
Mm-hmm.
And the scripture in that verse says that's the time I was carrying you.
That's
all
right.
My life I've been seeing two steps in the same. I've been seeing it. But Lord, it looked like you abandoned me. In the time when I needed you the most.
Needed you the most.
But they just didn't know. That's the time. God was caring.
That's right.
You thought you were by yourself.
Yes,
but that's the time when God was caring.